Wow. I knew that Logan was going to be brutal. I hoped it would be brutal, but I was not prepared that the deepest cuts would be emotional. I mean, this is a fucking tour de force. They swear a lot in the movie. I mean, it's earned, it fits, but boy, there's a lot of swearing in here. So I say with the utmost respect that this is a fucking tour de force for Hugh Jackman, Patrick Stewart, and James Mangold. And congrats, non-comic book readers, you finally get to meet Wolverine. This is the first time that I've seen a comic book character accurately portrayed on the silver screen as they are in the comics. Like, we've seen special things done with comic book characters on the big screen before, but never have I watched a movie and said, I feel like I'm reading one of those comic book stories. I had that feeling a little bit with the first Avengers, but that's a whole different type of story. Wolverine comics tend to be a little bit, have a little more drama, a little more story in them. You know, it's not like 90% fighting. So to have that transposed to the big screen is incredibly satisfying. And also, for all of you who like to still read out comic books as the funny pages, right? Or like a lesser form of storytelling. Well, I'm telling you, this is what we're reading. You're getting it right here. And this is from the very first scene. The first scene, I felt like, again, I was reading a Wolverine story. It was perfect on every level. And that, of course, includes the fighting. It was a thrill to finally see a Wolverine fight done correctly, brought to life on the big screen. It was just as magical as I'd hoped it would be. I was like, that's exactly how he would do it. And it wasn't overly gory. I mean, it was just right, you know? Like, they didn't err on the side of caution. They didn't go for overkill. But it looked like it hurt. It looked like it hurt everyone involved, and I loved it. And we're not just talking fight choreography and visual effects here. We're talking camera work. And also the score. I thought the music was used incredibly well here. And they saved Johnny Cash just for the credits. So the score here, it's not just cheats with, you know, songs. The score is incredibly well done. But you know what else is good? The script. I mean, it would have to be to be telling a Wolverine story the way I just said. But I think we have to talk about the script in its own special section because that's very rare for comic book movies, still, unfortunately. It had amazing one-liners. It did a great job exploring relationships, but it also did a great job in what it chose to leave unsaid, both emotionally and in terms of story points. It was very sophisticated, you know? It asked you to fill in a lot of the blanks, but without directly asking you to do so. You have to really pay close attention. I think that's one way that this movie will benefit from repeat viewings. I don't know how many repeat viewings it's going to get. We're going to talk about some of its very few flaws at the end of the review. This is no spoilers though, so don't worry about that. But I think on the screenwriting front, it's definitely worth at least one more visit to try and pick up on some of the things that were, I think, even by the end of the movie, still not clarified, which I thought was great. I really liked that choice. And they didn't need to be clarified. You got the overall idea. And you got the same idea that the characters were getting. And I think that was part of the experience. I think the magic ingredient in the script might be James Mangold, because the other two screenwriters, with all due respect to them, I mean, they did contribute to the script, so yay. But Scott Frank worked on the last Wolverine, and Michael Green helped out with Green Lantern. So I'm thinking that Mangold's the one that made, he was the special sauce here. And it goes to show how important it is who you hire to write these movies. We talk so much about the directors, and I think that the writer should be just as important a conversation, not just amongst us. I mean, of course, we would take it seriously, but I hope that the studio executives would realize that as well, particularly when you get results like this. The movie also, to my surprise, reminded me of a Terminator movie, T2 in particular. But not like, hey, you ripped off Terminator, but like, hey, here are two great movies that have a surprising amount of overlap that I had not seen before. And this movie makes it very clear. It also makes you miss Terminator movies. I'd also like to point out on that note that there are a lot of surprises in store for you when you see this movie. This year, you know, last year was the year of like, did you show too much in the trailer? And people have been worried about this year. So far, like Cure for Wellness, they had like a ton of stuff they didn't show. Here, I was amazed at how much had not been revealed about the movie. And I was very, very impressed with that. So beware spoilers. And they're just really, it's really great. Because some of you might be like, how is it like a Terminator? You'll see. All right. Then as for performances, Hugh Jackman. This has been his signature role for 17 years. I can't believe he's been playing this character for 17 years. And with this movie, he locks that shit down forever. This is forever his. It was so impressive. He also made me cry. This movie made me cry a lot. You want to have like tissues coming out of your fists like Wolverine's claws? Like we're not talking like, oh, I'm teary-eyed. We're talking like a single tear down my cheek. You know, on my, you know, I was going to say 3D glasses. I had my regular glasses on. We watched this in 2D. And it was great. Just a single tear. I was like, oh my God. And then Patrick Stewart also made me cry. The subtleties and the rawness of both their performances is something to behold indeed. And there isn't a single ounce of vanity in either of their performances. And a lot of love for the characters they're playing. This is the antithesis of the paycheck gig. And it was so fabulous to be able to experience that. Then Boyd Holbrook, he makes one heck of an introduction for himself. His first scene is one of the best conversations in a movie that is full of great conversations. Like, this is one of those movies. You know how we talk about people fast forward from action sequence to action sequence? Well, this is a movie where you will stop for some of the conversations as well and want to see them play out again. They're just that good. It's so nice to have a good script. it's so wonderful. But as the film goes on, the movie needs Boyd Holbrook's character less and less, so he kind of fades into the background a little bit. Then as for Dafne Keen, she knocks her fighting scenes out of the park, and she is 110% believable as a baby Wolverine. However, she doesn't have Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart's likability factor. Part of that is built into the story, and you'll see that when you watch the movie, but part of it, unfortunately, is just the actress. And maybe with a child, it's hard. Like, what do we go for? Do we go for someone who can sell the fight scenes, or do we go for someone who can sell the emotional scenes? And of course you go with the fight scenes. That's the most important in a movie like this. And even if she was a little bit more personable, I think that the script doesn't give her a moment to call her own outside of the action sequences anyway. So I think that also hurts her character. But I felt I never really got to know X-23. But then also, in addition to that, as far as flaws go, most of this movie is perfect. Absolutely perfect. But the third act, I actually kind of resent the movie a little bit for the third act. And we'll talk about that in the spoiler review closer to when the film is released, because I don't want to give away the spoilers. But I'm talking, I resent the choices that were made in the third act, both story-wise and also in terms of message. And I think, speaking of message, one problem this film is going to potentially have is it's going to come across as being political. Now, I don't know if that's intentional or if it ended up being amped up more than they had intended by the way things have developed, particularly here in the United States, but I know that there are certain things that are a problem, that are like a real hot button sensitive issue across the globe, and this movie kind of taps into that. Let me just say, if the Budweiser Super Bowl commercial annoyed you, this movie's gonna make your head explode. And so I feel kind of bad that because of the third act choices that this movie makes, in a number of areas, it might hurt the film's commercial prospects. So I will be curious to see how it does at the box office long term. You know, it's gonna be huge the first weekend, but I do worry about repeat business, word of mouth a little bit because of that, particularly in red states, let's say, all right? But I will say finally that, because for the most part, and this is the only thing that keeps us from being them being equal, but this is very, very, very close to The Dark Knight in terms of quality when it comes to comic book movies. And while Marvel Studios' formula has been incredibly successful, they should be a little bit nervous, because now Fox is 2 for 2. Because what Fox is starting to do with their Marvel movies is awe-inspiring. And it's the kind of work that we'd hope to see with the genre, the comic book genre, post-Nolan, but that didn't materialize. And now it is materializing over at Fox, which is crazy when you think about it, considering what they've had to go through. But maybe that was part of the process. But they have come out on the other end making movies of the quality, just shy of the quality of The Dark Knight. I'm that impressed. So we will be discussing this for sure more as in much more detail as we get closer to the film's release, but I'm so happy to tell you that you should definitely buy your Logan tickets and bring tissues. All right, write your thoughts down below. If you have by any chance seen the film, do not spoil it for anyone. And you can check out some other videos right now.